Australia. Thank you so very much. Well, thank you for joining us. This is the communion service, and the communion is a holy sacrament instituted by the Lord Jesus Christ in remembrance of the significance of his body and his blood, broken and shed for the remission of sin. Easter, which we celebrated just a week ago, was an ample opportunity to thank him for his unfathomable love for mankind. For the Bible says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." What a blessing. Yes, God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Awesome, truly indeed. The love of God is unconditional, unquenchable, and we are so grateful. And what's more, we died with him. We were buried with him. We resurrected with him. And guess what? Now we are seated together with him at the Father's own right hand in the heavenly places, far above all principality, all power and might and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this world, but also in that which is to come. Glory, hallelujah! Easter was an amazing time of just reflecting on all that he did for us. We could never thank him enough. Well, 2024 is moving on so fast, just as foretold by our man of God at the beginning of the year. Can you just think about it? The second quarter has already begun, but it was like January was just yesterday. And the first quarter of the year, redemption, it was phenomenal. What do you think? Our knowledge of the word increased. We propagated the gospel globally through exceptional initiatives and means, and we wrought great miracles in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we affected everywhere in our world by the power of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Destroy the works of truth granted us absolute grace and divine favor in all ramifications. Testimonies abound. Glory to God. We are eternally grateful to the Lord for the global impact of the following exceptional ministry programs that were organized in the month of formations and really helped to ensure that we were on top and in charge through the month. Number one, Your Love Was Specials, Season 9, Phase 2, where our man of God talked more extensively on the book of Revelation. Were you a part of it? Our man of God brought to light current happenings in our world and their spiritual significance. I'm sure you're a part of it, and we look forward to the one in this month of April. Then we had 10 for 10th. The 10th edition of the Healing Streams Live Healing Services with great man of God, Pastor Chris. It was a three-day power-packed event. Whoa! Where the power of our Lord Jesus Christ was amply demonstrated. Wow! We had greater dedication to the manifestation of the healing power of God and the man of God. You set up places. Did you invite others? It was awesome. Each new session always surpasses the former in glory. And we're so grateful to our man of God for the Healing Streams Life Healing Services. You know, many on the healing lines, they received their healing either by the laying of hands, while others were declared healed by the words of the Spirit. Remember, there was a healing line physical, and there was a healing line virtual. And then when the man of God released words to everybody else viewing, boy, oh boy, there were testimonies everywhere. And I hope you've been a part of the Festival of Miracles, where we actually heard so much more of what happened during those 3 days. And the testimonies continue. Glory to God. That's not all. After that, we had the week-long, educative, blissful, insightful, and glorious group of programs with our man of God, Pastor Chris, joined by, yes, you were there, right? Pastor Benny Hinn, Dr. John Avanzini, Bishop James Payne, Bishop Clarence McClendon, Dr. Mike Smalley, and Pastor Dan Willis. Ooh, woo, woo, woo. Those programs, which include Your Love Well Praise-a-thon, 5 days of destiny and the global day of prayer. Wow. Through these programs, we excelled in the grace of giving. We received words of blessings, and we caused activities in our world to align with the Father's will. It was just phenomenal. And brothers and sisters, all of that happened in just 1 month, only in Love World. What do you think? Glory to God. So I am letting you know that you were in the right place at the right time, tuned in to be a part of this service. And in this service, this today's Global Communion service, our man of God, Pastor Chris, is going to be ministering in the fullness of the blessing of Christ. There's only one thing you need to pay for this. Guess what it is? No. You don't have to pay any money at all. Just pay your attention. Amen. The Bible says, my son, give me your heart. Give me your ear. Pay attention to my words. And in today's communion service, that's what you need to do. Just rid yourself of anything that would distract you. Get your pen, get your notebook, get your Bible ready, and participate actively in every segment so that you can receive that special grace that you require for a glorious second quarter of the year of redemption. So you can do something. Even though I want you to focus for yourself, you can use the few seconds that we have left in my introduction to prompt those in your sphere and tell them that it started. They should log on. They can use the live TV app or any of our other social media apps or platforms. And you can use CFlix, CTunes, Alpha TV. Get on the website. You'll find us anywhere. Just make sure. And we're also on TV, you know. So tell others. Give them a link and let them be a part of it. And I can guarantee you one thing. You're not going to leave this program the same. For the power of God is mighty where you are. So on behalf of Love World, I want to thank you once again for joining us. And if you wouldn't mind, if you are where you can, just rise to your feet. If you're in a car or it's not convenient, just sit where you are. But if you are where you can stand, would you kindly rise? Because we're going to have our Love World singers lead us in a rendition of the Love World anthem. Once again, you are welcome to the April 2024 communion service with our great man of God, Pastor Chris. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Welcome to the prayer segment of the April 2024 Global Communion Service with our dear man of God, Pastor Chris. May I kindly request that you get ready for this special time, and I'll be asking you to kindly stand up or take a very comfortable but inspiring prayer position so that we can pray with intensity. Praise God. I'm so grateful to my dear man of God for the blessed opportunity to lead this special prayer segment at this time. The first thing we'll be praying about is a prayer of thanksgiving for the first quarter. Yes, already in this beautiful year of redemption, one quarter is done, but the blessings will continue. Praise God. In Psalm 72, verse 18 to verse 19, the Bible says, "Blessed be the Lord God, the God of Israel, who only doeth wondrous things, and blessed be his glorious name forever, and let the whole earth be filled with his glory." Amen and amen. So first, we're going to thank the Lord for the impact, the global and the eternal impact of our incessant prayers. You know, Lord Jesus said we should pray without ceasing, and that's exactly what we're doing. The Bible tells us to do that. Pray without ceasing. It says men ought always to pray. That's what the Lord Jesus said. And in 1 Thessalonians 5:17, the Apostle Paul said, pray without ceasing. And then we're also thanking the Lord for our unending praise, for our continual faith-filled declarations, our global evangelical initiatives in the first quarter, and the exploits that we did, that we accomplished in the first quarter of 2024. There were so many beautiful things that happened, and that themselves are producing more unending results for us. So we're going to thank the Lord lavishly for the increased grace and the manifold blessings that we enjoyed, by nations within the just concluded quarter. Because, you know, as we prayed and interceded, we effected changes and made many beautiful things begin to happen in nations. So we're thanking the Lord that through our prayers, many nations were extricated from detrimental associations and treaties by the church. The church ensured that this happened. Hallelujah. So we're going to thank the Lord also for his goodness, his tender mercies experienced around the world according to his perfect will. Let us pray now. Please stand up if you can and pray. Pray thanking the Lord for a glorious first quarter 2024. Oh, thank you, precious Lord. Thank God that you were part of the prayers, a part of the praise, a part of the programs, a part of the evangelical activities. Zakoski makatele boskin taramarando. We did so much individually, we did so much in groups across our various churches. Zakoski Marista, Malenko Zibankata Balenko Tobarashate, Razo Kadimantarabaya, Malekoski Timarishi, Rakontos Gunta, Bakele Botina, Mante Rizunta, activities. The righteousness was multiplied all over the earth, in every nation, every habitable part of the world. Yes, the impact of our prayers, of our praise, of the works of righteousness was felt everywhere. And the fragrance of God's presence was spread everywhere. And there's an increase in the knowledge of the glory of the Lord. And this will continue from glory to glory to the rapture. Lift up your voice and thank the Lord. Give him praise and honor. Malekirobo Rosa. The word says that of the increase of his government and of his peace, there shall be no end. And yes, through our activities, oh yes, there's an increase. There's an increase in the government. There's an increase in the influence. An increase in the peace, hallelujah, of our Lord Jesus Christ everywhere. Laboro zonda, makuta karabaya, rebosko bakatele konto rezinka, matorasha, makupa papatele konto kubarizekele bosonto, and it shall continue to be so. Yes, for this is the day of the church. This is the day of the church. Hakatiba leketoro zonda, male riboske bangarabalendo zonto shikere maraza, oribarondo zobale keteble. Thank God for the changes that happened in your city, in your nation in the first quarter 2024. Thank God for the things that you experienced. Hallelujah. Even in your community, see the glory of God. Bring them to remembrance and lift up your voice and give him praise. Makuba katila koshanka mariza boska orebozo motereke tupakala manterize nkalobotika orasante. Thank God for the soul. That poured into our churches, the evangelical activities, yes, bringing the gospel to many. Many lives were changed, many lives transformed. Every day was a glorious day, yes, and our path, like that of the just, was as a shining light that just kept shining brighter and brighter, day to day, week to week, and in every month of the first quarter, it was victory upon victory. Jeke bakatele borososo, marizakatele bontakara mama meleketoski razosa maruza bakele bondo urazakale bote rezo razon takare bale. Oh, thank you, precious Lord. Thank you, glorious Father. We are grateful. We thank you for your word, the scriptures that give us light. We thank you for the sweet Holy Spirit guiding us every step of the way. We thank you for the authority that we have in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for qualifying us and trusting us, yes, to enforce your will in the earth. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. The church is marching on. Continue to mount up and to multiply. And in every nation on the face of the earth, yes, the name of our Lord will continue to be glorified. We bless your name, Father. We worship you. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. We're still praying. We're still praying. Now we're going to pray, thanking the Lord specifically for the month of March. Oh, the month of March was the month of formations. The month of formations. And with that message, we receive graces. The man of God said the Lord will position us and organize us. And that's exactly what happened. In the month of formations, we receive immense opportunity to organize, to position, and to deploy effective strategies with tremendous spiritual implications. We were rightly positioned and had. They were orchestrated by the Holy Spirit. The timing, the manner of the program, we're grateful to the Lord for that. And some of those programs, let me just mention them to you. You, of course, remember, but if maybe somehow you do not remember any of them and you missed the opening address by the Alice in Pastor Foma, I'll mention them to you now. In the month of March alone, we had the 10th edition of the Healing Streams Live Healing Services with our dear man of God. Yes. And then we had the Your Love Us Special, Season 9 and Phase 2. And then the Your Love World Praise-a-thon. And then the 5 days with Destiny. And then the glorious day of prayer, the global day of prayer, the 17th edition. And all of this happened in the month of March, the month of formations. Each of those programs by themselves would have been worthy of an annual program. But all those programs happened in just the month of March, the month of formations. And we're so grateful to the Lord for the avalanche of testimonies of salvation, of healing miracles, increased grace, increased knowledge of the word, increased wisdom, increased finances, divine favor, and all other numerous blessings received during those programs, incredible blessings. And let me tell you, as much as we have experienced so far, there's so much more that will come, so much more that will keep happening by the deposits and the things initiated through this program. So where you are now, lift up your holy hands and be truly grateful. You were part of those programs. Thank the Lord for what you received, what has started to happen through you, for you, and by you, because of this program. Oh, every program came with a definite and unique grace. Every program came with indelible impact, hallelujah, that will continue on from glory to glory. The services may have ended, but the impact continues and continues to multiply, continues to proliferate. The miracles are durable, the testimonies are birthing more testimonies, and the unending victories continue to rise from glory to glory. Thank you for the word that was ministered in each of those programs. There was an effective and efficacious ministry of the word of God. Hallelujah. Yes, yes, yes. The ministry of the spirit of truth through these programs that has gone into all the world, that is still working and making impact everywhere. Marisa Kopakari Boski, Rajatalaba, pray specially that the unending impact of these programs will not only penetrate every known territory, every place where there's human habitations, but would also saturate the noise of the programs, the testimonies from the programs, the results of the programs will continue in unending fashion. The healing streams are still flowing in the name of Jesus. The administration of the word, yes, that came to us through the programs continues to manifest. Yes, that which we received as the light of the world, we are shining brighter and brighter. So the world will continue to feel the impact of those programs. Every territory, every nation, every family, every man, every woman, every boy, and every girl, Leborosonta, will benefit from those programs in the aftermath, in the name of Jesus. Zakoba Kateli, Korosonto, Malekota Karabale, Rando Zinka, Toba Rasha Karabale Skunda. Oh, Father, we give you praise. Your word says, whatsoever the Lord doeth, it is forever. So we know that the blessings and the benefits from these programs, they are forever. And for this, we're grateful. For this, we're grateful. Shabu katuma rashantara baris. Kelutuma katele boroso razon katalabaya. Oh, wherever you are, one more time, just lift up your holy hands. Lift up your hands and just thank the Lord for the tremendous, indelible, incalculable impact of the programs that we had in the month of formation. We prayed about the programs. We expected the programs, and the programs happened, and our expectations were exceeded. Hallelujah. More than we expected, the Lord did for us. We cannot forget. We will not forget. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, blessed Father. We are grateful. We are grateful. Hallelujah. Oh, glory be to God. Glory be to God. We're still praying. We're still praying. Hallelujah. Now, I want us to think about this month of April. If the first 4 months of this year of redemption have been the first 3 months, if they've been as we have experienced, beyond imagination, what would this month of April be like? What would it be like? But I tell you, you're in the right place at the right time. And right now, just begin to thank the Lord that you're the one where you're sitting, you're the one where you're standing, you're the one that's connected to this program at this time. Because from this program, you will certainly continue in a path of glory. Yes, where you are now is the right place. This is exactly where the Lord wants you to be. You might as well say you are right now in the center of God's perfect will for you. And going forward, your feet will not slide. your steps will not falter. You will continue from glory to glory. The Bible tells us, Proverbs chapter 4, verse 18. I think we should look at it. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 18. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 18. Look at what the Bible tells us. It says to us here, it says, but the path of the just is as the shining light that shineth more and more unto the perfect day. No conditions attached. It doesn't matter which location. It doesn't matter what others are doing. The just here refers to those that are in God's will. It says your promotion is not negotiable. It is going to continue from glory to glory. Today is a good day. Tomorrow will be more glorious. The next week, by the time we come for the communion service in May, the testimonies would have been too much to mention. Just go ahead and thank God that it will be to you according to God's word. Hallelujah. Yes, your path in this month of April, as the path of the just, shining more and more, shining more and more from glory to glory. Kabora zakati matoskinte rabosaka maroshe karoshe keroposonto lakunda. Oh lebos kalemonto zingere borazanta la bakati loboroso. What a glorious, gracious God we serve. Yes, who has planned everything for us? He has made all things beautiful. Bare zakanto bakati leboroso lento zingata la bobobota. Thank you Lord, thank you precious Father. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. You know, similar to the scripture I just read to you, 2 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 14, that's another scripture that gives us the assurance of our unending victory. Praise God. Look at it. It says, now thanks be unto God, which always causeth us to triumph. There's orchestration by the Spirit, guaranteeing that always we triumph. Oh yes, there will be challenges, but we'll win them all the time. There'll be things we're going to deal with, but yes, our victory is assured. And so it says to us here, look at it. It says, now thanks be unto God, which always caused us to triumph in Christ. And I like the second part. It says, and make it manifest the savour of his knowledge by us in every place. This will be the testimony. Everywhere, the fragrance of God would dominate. The goodness of the Lord would dominate. The will of God would dominate. Go ahead and pray. This will be your testimony in your activities, individually, in groups. This will be the testimony. Victory upon victory. We triumph only. And we manifest the fragrance of God. We manifest the blessings of God. In the name of Jesus, we are on divine assignment. Yes, sakabale kotobo roshon. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. So every nation, every territory will be blessed. We'll receive the blessings of God. And it's the will of the Father that will prevail. In the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, precious Lord. Hallelujah. Now, I want you to understand that scripture very carefully. It says, now thanks be unto God, which always caused us to triumph in Christ. The word triumph there means that there'll be contests, there'll be conflicts, but we'll win all the time. You see, we'll win all the time. So whether it's on an individual level, or as a group, you come and you collide with things that must shift, that must change, your victory is guaranteed. It will cause you to triumph. It will cause you to triumph. And then not only will you triumph, there will be the fragrance of God in that place because of you. It will be your testimony. The man of God told us in our Rhapsody of Reality several days ago, we are on divine assignment. We are on divine assignment. In your office, in your home, in your neighborhood, in your nation. Because of you, the fragrance of God will spread. Because of you, the works of righteousness will multiply and will prevail. Yes, this month of April, what a glorious month it shall be for us. Hallelujah. Praise God. We're still praying. During the Global Day of Prayer, the 17th edition, in the closing moments of that Saturday session with our dear man of God, the man of God gave a word. A word. He gave us a word from the Spirit. I encourage you to get it, to relieve the moments on Cflix or any of our networks. But here's what the God said. And I'm saying it the way I internalized it. He said it's an hour, the hour in the kingdom of promotion, the hour of increase. Then he said, the Lord will multiply our abilities and that our results from efforts will increase. Then he spoke of divine favor we're entering into. So many blessings from that word at this time. I want us to pray, because you see, when the word comes like that, there are three things that are important. The first is you've got to believe it for yourself. That's number one. Number two, you have to affirm it. You've got to confess it. You've got to agree with that word. You've got to say it again. You've got to say, yes, it will be to me according to those words. It's my month of increase. It's my hour of increase. And then the third, you walk in the consciousness of it. There's promotion for you. There's increase for you. Favor for you. Your abilities are multiplied and your efforts to produce greater results. The Lord has done it already. It came to us by the Spirit through the man of God. All you need to do is to enjoy it and enjoy it and enjoy it. Throw your hands in the air and say, Lord, it is mine in the name of Jesus. That which you've appointed unto me, the increase, the promotion, the greater favor, it's mine in the name of Jesus. I walk in the blessings. I walk in all the advantages you've appointed unto me for your glory, for your glory, for your good pleasure in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lakos katia, makaboro zoko bakatele baba baba rando. Orezenkendo zunto jikera maro jakata. Oh, thank you, gracious Lord. Thank you, bakele boski nantarabaya. For the sweet Holy Spirit, whom you said will show us things to come, He will guide us into all truth. Hallelujah! And He's doing just that for us. We are grateful. Thank you for the ministry of our dear man of God. Thank you for giving us a prophet. Hallelujah. At this time, Bale Koro Shuntalabaya. Barozekindus Kobankarabatin Karozontoli Kutikid Maraza. It will be to us according to your word. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we worship you. Blessed Father, we're grateful to you. Lord, we thank you for our service today, the Global Communion Service with our dear man of God, this April edition. Father, thank you for all that you've planned, ordained, appointed for us to receive. Thank you for the lives that will be changed. And Lord, even at this time, we thank you for everyone that should be connected to this broadcast. Lord, as many as are connected will be attentive. And those that are not yet connected, but that should be connected, they will not miss the moment of their visitation. Even at this time, we pray in the name of Jesus that there will be a divine orchestration to bring them in contact with the word that they will hear, that they should hear, that would change their lives and bring your blessings into their situation. Father, we thank you. We are grateful. Glory be to your name forever. We worship you and we honor you. Thank you, Lord. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank you, Lord. Oh, Rashama.
Abraham searched for a city whose builder and maker is God. Experienced the journey of a lifetime with the promised land. a book that will ignite your faith and empower you to live a life of abundance. Delve into the depths of God's promises and the secrets to abundance in The Promised Land by Reverend Chris Oyakhilome DSC, DSC, DD. This powerful book unlocks the divine vouchers God has given you. Learn how to live by these principles and enjoy the good of the land. Get your copies today. Get 30% off when you purchase in ESPYs. Use ESPYs code LWPM, reference, The Promised Land, throughout the month of April when you purchase on www.loveworldbooks.org. This offer is only valid in April. Don't miss out.
You know, we've got lots of new songs. And one of the things we've done now is to put many of these songs in a book form. We used to have one, we had a title, Songs of Zion. So, but that's an old one. That's an old one. We don't even sing those songs anymore. We've got new ones now. Songs of Heaven is the title of this one. So this is volume one, contains some of the songs, and then the next volume will have other songs because we can't put all of them. We are coming out with new songs all the time. Think about it. New songs all the time. The scripture tells us to sing a new song to God. And it says that several times in the scriptures, several times. So think how often we should come up with these new songs. So these ones are available. I hope you already have them in your congregation. So make sure to get your copy and start using them. Start using them in the church. Get them in the church so when they come in, they can pick and just start singing them. And they can take them home with them. So make sure you have your copy. That's why it's small, so you can put it in your purse, in your handbag, or in your pocket. Glory be to God.
To enable God's people all over the world worship Him in spirit and in truth, as instructed in His Word, the Songs of Heaven was birthed by the ministry of the man of God, Pastor Chris, and the nations shall be filled with the glory of His presence as we sing the Songs of Heaven to the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, and the God of all gods in all praise to the ends of the earth. And the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of His glory as the waters cover the sea. Every nation shall worship the Most High God, every home His sanctuary, every man His true worshiper. In the mouth of babes and sucklings shall His praise be ordained, and all creation shall sing His praise with the songs of heaven. Amen. Let us flood the earth with the songs of heaven, that our land may be cleansed, sanctified and saturated with the glorious presence of God. Let the nations of men, all tribes and tongues, lift their voice in praise to the Almighty God, for He alone is worthy to be praised. Praise Him, O ye people. The scriptures clearly show us that the Lord requires and deserves the very best of our sacrifice of praise. Hebrews 13 verse 15 says, "By Him therefore, let us offer the sacrifice of praise to God continually, that is, the fruits of our lips giving thanks to His name." There has never been a time in the history of the church when the true worship of the living God, the Creator of heaven and earth, has been so needed as it is today. This book will equip us with spirit-filled songs to worship God in spirit and in truth. All the songs in this book were written directly from the messages and teachings of the man of God, Reverend Dr. Chris Oyakhilome, DSC, DSC, DD. This songbook is for both the young and the old to worship during church services, family worship time, in schools, hospitals, at work, and private times, anywhere, anytime. For more information on how to get this book, contact the following numbers. The Pastor Chris Digital Library version 6 is now available on the Apple Store. All iPhone users can now have access to the Pastor Chris Digital Library, customized for you, and also the following features: PCDL Search, PCDL Everyday Solutions. PCDL for Kids. Testimonies. Growing with My Pastor. 8 days of meditation series and lots more. Download and update now. Pastor Chris Digital Library. Truly a place of solutions.
Introducing the latest addition to the Rhapsody Subscription Plus Bouquet, the Rhapsody Subscription Family Plan. A special package uniquely designed for families around the world. This family plan gives you access to 6 subscriptions every month. These include the Adult Rhapsodies, Rhapsody TiVo, Rhapsody for Kids, and Rhapsody for Early Readers. We have the 1 month, 3 months, and 12 months family subscription plans. Benefits. 1. A family of 6 can now log in into the same account and have access to the Adult Rhapsody of Realities. And from the Rhapsody bookstore on the app, have access to an edition of Rhapsody TiVo, an of edition Rhapsody for early readers, and 1 edition of Rhapsody for kids. 2. Save a whooping 50% on subscription cost and enjoy extra discounts on every purchase made with ESPYs. 1 month standard subscription costs for 6 people per month is 14 ESPYs. Under the family plan is 7 ESPYs. 3 month standard subscription cost for 6 people per month is 40 ESPYs. Under the family plan is 20.30 ESPYs. 12 month standard subscription plan for 6 people per month is 154 ESPYs. Under the family plan is 77 ESPYs. 3. You and your family have access to our over 20 full premium features, giving you and your family a rich study experience right on the app. 4. You can gift the Rhapsody Family Subscription to others by purchasing a Rhapsody Subscription Family Voucher on vouchers.rhapsodyofrealities.org and send the vouchers to other families. And 5. You can sponsor the Rhapsody Family Subscription Plans to families around the world, and we will distribute on your behalf. How to get started? Download the Rhapsody app from loveworldappstore.com. Sign up with your accurate details. Your account is to be shared, so use an email you can share with others. Click the Upgrade Subscription button and you are directed to the subscription page. Select Family Plan. Choose the family plan you wish to subscribe to. 1 month, 3 months, or 12 months subscription. Make payments and have instant access to your family plan. To sponsor and reach families around the world, call now the numbers showing on your screen. Don't miss this unbeatable deal. Get started today. Rhapsody of Realities, your guide for life.
Glory to God. This is the Global Communion Service with our man of God, Reverend Dr. Chris Okilame, DSC, DSC, DD, for the month of April. And we just brought you a lot of information on offers and some of the platforms that we want you to visit and take advantage of the beautiful products that will bless your life and ensure that the Word of God is constantly moving you in the direction of fulfilling your call in Christ. Hallelujah. But right now, we'd like you to pay attention because we're going to show you a very motivating and inspiring video. We're going to show you the highlights of the groundbreaking ceremony of the Inner City Mission. And guess where? The country of Liberia. And this has been done under the auspices of the Chris Okilame Foundation International. Watch this and be inspired.
The Liberian Civil War was a prolonged and devastating conflict that took place in the West African nation of Liberia. The war was characterized by widespread violence, human rights abuses, and displacement, and had a profound impact on the people and society of Liberia.
This is the epicenter of the outbreak. In a city of 1 million, almost 50 new cases are reported every day. Liberia's tiny band of healthcare workers are throwing everything they have at Ebola.
Liberia has gone through a lot over the years. This is a nation that has been affected by several different challenges. One that is well known is the war, the civil war that lasted for more than 20 years. So many things took Liberia back. In fact, according to one statistics, Liberia went back 30 years.
We also have children who have never been to school between the ages of 5 to 12 years old, because there's no school in the town and villages. And that is a greater challenge for our country.
The farm work I was doing, because the man one was going on with it, it was too much for me. The sister said, I call me here, and I turn it back on me. So God will help me, and my children then go to school.
Now my husband was helping me, he told me. My husband died. I get 14 children. The 14 children, 10 for myself. For my sister, who she died.
And when my father's people left from here, none of them show concern, none of them care about it. And my mom said no one should bother them. And just like that, so this year my mom will not have money to send me to school.
If the children are not educated 10 years from now, we start calling them the name that we call our brothers, the Zokos.
So get involved. Get involved and join us. Join us to reach young people, set up schools and training centers around the world.
Christian schools will be one of the major things, will be one of the big blessings to Liberia.
The team from the Chris Oyakhilome Foundation, the Inner City Mission, has just arrived to do a groundbreaking ceremony of the Inner City School Year in Liberia.
Right now we are at the grounds where the Inner City School gonna be constructed, and behind this bush that you see here is a whole lot of community that will benefit.
The coming of the school is a relief. And to many parents and people of the community where the school will be situated, it's going to be a big relief to all of them.
When I hear that free school coming in a community, I will be happy. I will be too happy. I will be happy for it. Because when the school come, it will help me. It help my children there. So all of them, so they can go to school free.
Today is a wonderful day for us in Liberia. It's a groundbreaking ceremony for the Inner City School here in Liberia.
On behalf of the founder of the Inner City Mission for Children, Reverend Chris Oyakhilome, DSC, DSC, DD, it is an honor and privilege to welcome you to a momentous occasion for the Kankan community and for Liberia as we gather to celebrate a truly groundbreaking moment, the beginning of the construction of the first ever 100% free Inner City Mission School in Liberia.
With this school, we know that in this community, we're going to have a lot more children being schooled, a lot more of them being gainfully employed and being productive, that will lead to the betterment of the nation.
And for every child that is going to attend this school, for every parent that is going to bring a child to this school, I'd like to make you understand that you are stepping into a place of a very broad vision.
Pastor Chris, what you have done, it is only God that will bless you. Our children that we have been crying for, the doors are open.
Every time you hear Pastor Chris, he's a great healer, all the one through Jesus Christ. But now, they have come to the point that he has come to the humanitarian aspect. So we want to be so, so grateful.
We received this property, landed property, for the construction of the 100% free Inner City Mission School.
I'm very proud to be a part of history making today.
that we will witness for the first time in the history of Liberia, unprecedentedly, the construction of an institution that will be 100% free.
Today marks the beginning of glorious things that will happen with this school, with the children, and for this community.
You sold us. Every child is your child, and that is what has brought us all the way to Monrovia in Liberia, in this Kankan community, to reach out to the children here and establish a 100% free inner city mission school.
What I'm excited about is the fact that these ones are going to be impacted spiritually, that our gospel is going to be taught them.
So we went there, the people say a lot of things that encouraged me as a child. The people said they are going to pay school, everything will be free of charge.
When we educate the children, reduce the zogos and the zogis to be able to contribute meaningful to the society.
Cool. In the name of the Lord Jesus, ministers, hallelujah, Maregedo City, heads of government, in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Join the Inner City Mission to make a difference in the lives of indigent children by sponsoring their education for the academic session, building Inner City Mission schools, and sponsoring.
I want to say a great, great, big, big thank you to Amon and of God our Spirit. We're praying for the nation where you live or work, and we are going to be prophesying peace, prosperity, righteousness, and the proliferation of the gospel and the churches of Christ. We're also going to be praising God for the impact and effect of words spoken through the power of the Spirit over each of these countries during the just concluded Global Day of Prayer. The Bible says, by the blessings of the upright, the cities are exalted, and righteousness exalts a nation. Your nation is going to be exalted, no matter the plans of the devil, of the deep state. To their consternation, nations have been extricated from poverty, from lack, from scarcity, and they are being ushered into prosperity. We're going to proclaim the establishment of the Father's will on each of our nations as revealed in the Word of God and by the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. So I'd like us to just stand up right now and go ahead and pray for the nations of the world. Pray specifically for the nation where you live and where you work. Prophesy. Malegroto Santa Ligratelibando Shangridista La Grando Supre de Calabando Bredobu Shantalabakida Marigoto Bruchantalabasenda Lama Sucre de Baya Le Grando Shandalabas Santa Lakideba Marigobo Sucre de Balabaya Mande Greshontolibakita Farikto Shangrada Balabas Sandalabaya. We are praying just not only for the nation, but for the people of the nation. In the name of Jesus, Ligra Sandalabaya, Barakasataya, Barakaseketoya, Marakatalabaya. We bless Nigeria and the Nigerians, the people of Nigeria. We declare that they are blessed in the name of Jesus. Liga Basataya. We pray for the people of every nation of the world. Ligra Bondore Makalabashandalama Zikrondoba, Malakasa. Taya Rikatarabaya Legrazadalabaya Legrosungridiba Legrazandalabaya Rikatoshataya. We pray for North Korea and the North Koreans in the name of Jesus. We bless them with salvation. We bless them with prosperity. We bless them with health. We bless them with peace in the name of Jesus. We bless the nations with prosperity and productivity in the name of Jesus. Legabash Shatalamandi, Lega Basacredo Brondo Shatalabaya, Maracaseketo Soprendigada, Legrando Shandalabacalabando Sungredebaya, Maracrando Shenderebaraba Santaya, Barande Copasataya. We proclaim righteousness over the nations in the name of Jesus. Legra soprende calabas santa lamande, legrendo shakatalabando secredi, livagonde cabaracetia, maracato shindere balabas santa labaya, malacato shindere calabas santa raba, recoto shandalabaya. We proclaim the lordship of Jesus over nations, over all the nations of the world in the name of Jesus. Lege bondo rebacataraba, maracata shandalamande. Every word of prophecy, every word declared over the nations during the global day of prayer, I will not return empty, but they will come back with testimonies in the mighty name of Jesus. The impact is increasing. The impact of those words is increasing in the name of Jesus. The earth is full of the goodness of God. We declare that men everywhere are experiencing that goodness in the name of Jesus. The mechanisms of evil and iniquity, Baraka, they are dismantled in the name of Jesus. The influence of darkness is cut off from the nations. Maleko Shatalabaya, Maraka de Remondo Shandalaba Keremondo Sataya, Maleko Senderebaya, Rakato Shenderegalaba Santalabande, Legrendo Satalabaya. We declare proliferation of the gospel in the name of Jesus. The word of God has free course in every nation, is unstoppable in the name of Jesus. Lega basokredebaya, maleke sataya. We declare that every nation is open to the word of God, is open to the ministry of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. Leke satarabaya. This is the time of the church. This is the time of grace. This is the day of salvation. We proclaim waves of salvation. We declare that the word of God is increasing, is multiplying greatly in the name of Jesus. The hearts of men of every nation, they are open to the word in the name of Jesus. The light is shining through the darkness. The darkness cannot comprehend it. In the name of Jesus, this light of the glorious gospel is shining into the hearts of men everywhere, in every nation, every city, in every home. The will of God is established in every nation. Mareko Toshireba, Lakato Sendirabana Shendere Galabondos, Legrando Satalamande, Reketo Sundorebalama Shandalakia, Marakataya, Iramba Sataya. Every word we have spoken, Parekasada, they are words of kings and they are never void of power. They are full of power. They are producing results. They are decrees. They are signed in the name of Jesus. Kirabashata, they are producing testimonies. Thank you, Father, for the extrication, the redemption of nations.
wicked satire, from wickedness, from darkness, from wrong treaties, in the name of Jesus. We give you praise. We give you praise. We thank you, Mareko Shataya, because you told us to pray in the name of Jesus. Shout hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Right now, we're going to be watching a promo concerning the program.
By him, by Jesus, therefore, let us offer the sacrifice of praise to God continually, that is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name.
As God's people, our primary purpose for being is to offer praise unto the Lord our God.
In the New Testament, he calls us to offer spiritual sacrifices, to offer sacrifices of praise.
He tells us that to praise God is to bless him. To praise God is to thank him.
It's another sublime opportunity to offer the calves of our lips as sacrifices of praise and worship to the Lord Most High at this special praise night with Pastor Chris.
14th of April is a praise night, special praise night. It's going to be wonderful.
It will be live on Alpha TV, Love World Networks, Life TV mobile app, CFlix app, and social media platforms.
Pastor Chris. By God's Spirit, unravel the wholesome mysteries and secrets inscribed in the pages of the riveting book of the Revelation. Up to your Well, special season 9, phase 1 and 2.
And showed me that great city, the holy Jerusalem, descending out of heaven from God. He says, and I saw heaven opened, and behold a white horse, and 4 great beasts came up from the sea. And the 24 elders who sat before God on their thrones fell on their faces and worshipped God.
And now, join Pastor Chris on your Loveful special season 9, phase 3, as he takes the body of Christ into untapped realms of divine insights by the Spirit of God, as he also delivers a first-hand knowledge of ongoing events in our world, in line with the Father's prophetic calendar.
We know the truth of the hour. We know the truth of the times. We know what the world is supposed to be like today. What should it be like? What kind of a life should we be living in the world today? And because we know, we make it so.
Don't miss your Love World special season 9, phase 3, happening from Wednesday, April the 17th to Friday, April the 19th at 7 p.m. GMT plus 1 daily. It will be broadcast live on all Love World networks, the Live TV mobile app, CFlix mobile app, Alpha TV, See Love World, designated ministry websites, and various social media platforms. Don't miss it.
How can I make an impact? You.
To them, burning inside.
This is the year of redemption, and the call to win souls now burns more urgent than ever before. In these final hours of the church age, we've been commissioned to shine brighter than ever with the gospel of Christ's salvation, extricating men and nations from the clutches of darkness and ushering them into our glorious kingdom. This April, get set for the Soul Winners Congress 2024 with Pastor Chris, a strategic 3-day training program for soul winners in the Love Old Nation, taking place from Thursday, the 25th of April, to Saturday, the 27th of April, 2024. Now, more than ever before, it's time to get equipped
trained, and set ablaze for greater effectiveness in the divine calling to redeem men unto Christ as we preach the gospel everywhere.
I just received so much grace, heaped upon grace in my soul winning, in my outreach, in my soul meetings, everything concerning me, no struggle to win souls, no struggle to do anything, no struggle to hit my targets. It's been an awesome time, and I'm so grateful to Amanda God for all the inspiration, all the teachings.
I remember last year when I was talking about having a burning desire for winning souls. It's not enough to be aflame, it must be ablaze, burning for the things of God. Talking about the work of the Holy Spirit in our work of soul winning. But for me, Pastor Moshaki's statement was when he said that at the time I was already holding crusades, doing amazing things. He asked us the question, what is life like if you fully believe this gospel? What does life look like if you fully believe, you grasp everything what God has to say concerning him? And as I heard this, I was sitting down at the time and I thought to myself, what would my life be like? How much of God's word have I had laid a hold on, laid a grasp on? And I began to do immediately what God said that we should do. And you could see immediately the amazing changes that we had in the fellowship. You know, at the time, I was a cell leader, but now that cell has become three cells, you know, and soon to become another fourth one. We've had such amazing growth across all of our cells. You know, what we used to do as a fellowship, we now have some cells that are having that same number in attendance and giving. The growth has been amazing.
As I learned from Pastor Chris last year, he said, a leader be on fire. And yes, after that meeting, we were on fire. We are on fire and we are doing tremendous work in our cells, in our sphere of contact. After that meeting, we hold a big outreach in a village area where there were more than 250 people who attend that outreach and they received their salvation. Glory to God. And this year, in the Soul Winner Congress, I have expectation and I'm expectant that we are gonna learn so many things and we're gonna apply the same things in our real life and in our cell ministry and to win more souls for the kingdom.
When this thing starts working like this, you share the word, that guy goes and tells some other people and they bring them, they come and meet you. It's called supernatural evangelism.
It's time for Supernatural Soul Winning. Get ready for the Soul Winners Congress 2024 with Pastor Chris. The harvest is truly plenteous and the laborers are plenteous. To register, contact your zonal or ministry center office. God bless you.
Glory! Lovewood Next and Innovations in collaboration with the Lovewood Children Ministry and Schools presents the Glorious Joyful Children's Tournament.
Starting this April, the Pilgrim Board Game Tournament commences. Glory! So who is going to be the Pilgrim Champ? The tournament will be held across different groups, zones, and regions in all our churches. You can participate by registering for the tournament in your children's church and get the Pilgrim Board Game. A minimum of two kids and a max, and the winners in the group level will compete to be the Pilgrim Champ at the zonal level. And the winners at zonal level will compete to be the Pilgrim Champ for regional levels. Exciting, right? The age range for participation is between ages of 7 and 14. Pictures and short videos of the tournament with details of the winners are to be sent to the Pilgrim Board Game King's Church handle. There are lots of prizes to be won at every level. Pilgrim Board Game. Play, win, and learn about love.
You are no longer intimidated by figures. It's about what you want to do. What is it you want to do? What do you want to do? The money will come. Are you hearing me?
Rapathon with Pastor Chris. Rapathon with Pastor Chris is a time to showcase the heroic acts of the legendary book, Rhapsody of Realities. Get ready for amazing sessions, great and inspiring testimonies, beautiful exhortation. So much to go home with, so much to learn, so much inspiration. Get ready for so much more impartation, inspiration, prayer, and beyond incredible testimonies with Rhapsody of Realities, the number one devotional and one of the wonders of the world.
You think I plucked money from the Jeep? What? You don't?
Rapathon with Pastor Chris. Date, May 15th to May 18th, 2024. Don't miss it.
Be a redeemer every day with Rhapsody of Realities in the Year of Redemption. Seed daily. S. Sponsor. Sponsor 8,123 copies and be a Rhapsody Wonder. Sponsor Language Redemption Missions and be a Missions Redeemer. E. Engage. With Rhapsody Outreaches. E. Enlist new partners and others into the Rhapsody subscriptions plan. D. Distribute Rhapsody every day everywhere in print and digital formats to all ages and in all 8,123 languages. To take action now, call any of these numbers showing on your screen or contact your partnership manager. God bless you.
Wow, we are being loaded, and it's from glory to glory. We're going to be praying about these programs. The Bible says in the book of 1 John chapter 5 and verse 4, "For whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world, and this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith." Every one of these programs is born of God, and it is causing us to prevail over the systems of this world through the Praise Night, the Your Love World Specials, the Soul Winners Congress, and the Rapathon. We are rising to yet another level of glory. And the Bible tells us that our life is from glory to glory. So we're going to be praying, and we're going to be declaring the supply of God's Spirit concerning each of these programs. And we're going to be declaring that the impact will be an eternal impact in the lives of men, nations, cities, homes. I'd like us to stand up right now and go ahead and pray concerning the programs, the upcoming programs that we just saw in this promo. Barantu suprini bala kashata, marakasu turi bala mashanda la masikri do prundo shikiri ba, mariko bosungri di bala baya, maliko sukri di baya, makatala bashanda la baya kisu prundo shindi gala basanta. We declare that every one of these programs, Marakasataya, Mandi Kroshantaya, is producing an eternal impact. In the mighty name of Jesus, Malego Bosungre de Balaba Shandalaba, Barakate Krishunturibaya, Barakasataya, Marego do Shandalaba Zandalabakaya, Barego Sungre de Balama Shandaya, Riko Shunduri Balaba Sataya, through the praise night we execute judgment on the nations. Hallelujah, Masakataya, on the rulers of darkness, Barakasataya, the power of God is released. Mareko Shatalabaya, Barakato Sindiri Balakrabashundia. Through the Love World Specials, Mariko Shatalabaya, the knowledge of the Word of God is covering the earth as the waters cover the sea. The righteous are coming to a place of knowledge. Multitudes of laborers are being hatched out through the Soul Winners Congress.
Shatalabaya proliferating all over the earth. Maraks into the harvest field. Marego Boshatalaba. Marekoto Shatalabandi. Legrendo Parasataya. Rekazarabaya. Children of God, everywhere have been activated. Parakasa for soul winning. Lege Sotaya. Leke Zobranda. Mareko Shandalaba. Mareko Shandalaba. Rakatele Bondo Shataya. To the Rapaton. To the Rhapsody of Realities. Grace. Hallelujah. Is multiplied. Lekre Sontoreba. Everyone is a Rhapsody Center. Rika Shata. Receiving ability. Multiplied ability as prophesied by a man of God. Maraka Sataya. We declare that every one of these programs is a resounding success on a higher level than ever before, because it's from glory to glory. Malego soto rebaraba shata, mareko to shata, mareko sata, maleketa, barakataya, marakata, marego shonde, liza brando sekrendeya, marakataya. Everyone exceeding the previous one in glory. Hallelujah. Masata in impact. Hallelujah. Mareko shataya, mareko to rebaya, marakata rabaya, malakataya. Is ever increasing grace, ever increasing glory, ever increasing ministry. Hallelujah. Reka shataya, barakata, multiplied result, multiplied ability. Maleko shatalabandi, legre sotaraba, marendo shandaraba, lekrendo shandaraba, sandalaba, marakatoria. The impact of the kingdom of God is multiplied on all the nations through these programs in the mighty name of Jesus. Legrendo sataraba, marego shandalaba, bareko tosebre, legrando satalabaya, manda katalabaya, zerondo bajaba shatalaba. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Shout glory, somebody. Hallelujah. We're going to be praying, still praying for the nations. We're praying for salvation of souls in your country. The Bible says in the book of Psalm 2 and verse 8, it says, ask of me and I will give you, I shall give thee the hidden for thine inheritance and the uttermost parts of the earth for thy possession. We're going to be praying fervently in tongues of the Spirit, interceding for the salvation of souls around the world. We are praying specifically for the country where you are, your own country, that the work of the gospel will prosper exceedingly and that truth and righteousness will prevail to the glory of God. Let's go ahead and pray for salvation of souls. Malego bo shangranda bala sataya. Except Zion travail, she shall not bring forth. But as soon as Zion travail, she brought forth children. Malego bo sungre de balaktisa. Malakato branda lamando shanda lama zikrende sataramandi. Malego ro sondo de balakalamando shakrande kia. Makato sikrende balama shandala baya. Marakato shende de galaba sandala manduku sunturi manakeya. Marego do shandala basakatala mandu sungre de baya. Marego do shandala basunduri barakeya bashunduri bakaraba. Marego do shende de galaba satala mandi sunduri barakaraba. Barakato shunduri baya. Malakito sukrende balaba shandala baya. Marakato shende de galaba sunturi baragalaba shatala ba. Marego do shunduri barakalaba sikrendo parateya. Marego do shende de galaba sandala mandu koparateri ba. Malego sunduri barakalaba shandala ba zikrendo santa. Marego do shende de galaba. Santaya, Barakato Sikrindi Shandala Masataya, Marigo do Shindi Galabas Satara Mandi Kurobundo Shakaya, Marabuso Brindi Araka. Those that dwelt in darkness, they see a marvelous light in the name of Jesus. According to your word, to the uttermost parts of the earth, salvation comes to the hearts of men, conviction comes to the hearts of men. The Spirit of God is poured out upon all humanity. Hallelujah. do barik tere mando shakalabando sendeba malego sendele baraba regedo shandalabaya. We declare that conviction is coming to their hearts in the name of Jesus. When they come in contact with the message, they will come under conviction. Obadita lira ba shandalaba mareko tore barabaya shandalaba marego no shendere galaba sekrendo sendeya legrendo shakalabaya legrendo sandalabaya barada lama shandalabaya pirando shikredi mandeketo sataya. In the palaces is happening, in the government houses it is happening, hallelujah, in institutions it is happening. Conviction everywhere. Mareko shandalaba katarabaya marego no shendere baya legrendo sendere ba. Men are coming to salvation. Men are coming to the knowledge of the truth. Barakato shandalaba lekrando sataya. The old, the young, the rich, the poor, maleke sataya barakataya. The minds of men, their thoughts have been arrested by the power of the Holy Spirit, by the weapons of our warfare. My mighty name of Jesus. Sobrede kalabandi luzege de barata rakato semde bakalama shontaraba balekro dosedi lekrando sobrede kalama shandalaba. We declare that the work of the gospel is prospering. Hallelujah. The work of Rhapsody is prospering. The work of the healing school is prospering. The work of the ministry arms are prospering. In our zones, the work in our churches, the work in our groups, in ourselves, are producing a wave of salvation covering the whole planet. Marego sataraba, marego shandaraba, legrendo shandaraba, marego doreba shondeya, riba katarabando shendeya, legrendo sondarebaya. Every activity, barando shandalaba, ricatore manabo sopradeya, legrendo baratere bandi, ribaramondo shenderebaya, to the uttermost parts of the earth. Liza bring. The eyes of people's understanding have been enlightened, flooded with light. The light of the glorious gospel is penetrating hearts everywhere. In the mighty name of Jesus, through our work, we are taking nations, we are taking cities for Jesus Christ. Every blindness, every veil that was put on the hearts of men has been torn down by the power of the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, leke sataya. We declare that the gospel has free course, and is producing fruits in every place by the power of the Holy Spirit. Le grace sopradicta rato seketeya lakato branda lamando shakrede varindo sondeya le grando parikte le garondo shandalaba sekrende riba baba shandalaba kondoria marego do shenere bara ricatoro mando shadaba le grando paratalaba shanta le gero bondo seriba marego do shenere bara kidaba Santa Mare Cotorebara Barakataya Bajon de Barakara Malego do Shenigalaba Santa Baregrambo Shenigala Licato Baraya. Father, we thank you in the mighty name of Jesus. Salvation is coming to every nation, to every city. Hallelujah. All nations have been delivered to us. We receive them to the uttermost parts of the earth in Jesus' mighty name. We are still praying. Hallelujah. Right now, we're going to be praying for Christians all over the world. We're going to pray fervently in tongues, thanking the Lord for his wisdom at work in us, the church of Jesus Christ. Glory to God. In Ephesians 5 verse 15, the Bible says, "See then that you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise." In the book of Romans, chapter number 16, from verses 17 to 18, the Bible says, "Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which you have learned, and avoid such. For they that are such serve not our Lord Jesus Christ, but their own belly, and by good words and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple." We're going to be declaring and praying
that wisdom is exalted in the heart of every Christian. Pastor told us at the New Year's Eve service that we were going to walk in a new manifestation of wisdom this year. We're going to be declaring that we function with the wisdom of God and we walk circumspectly at all times and under all circumstances, even as the day of our rapture approaches. Glory to God. Let's go ahead right now and pray for our brothers and sisters all over the world. Maki shupratalabandi, barakito prandalaki sokrindi balabashatalabaya. Malego boshong de digalabas santanabaya. Makatalabashakalabas sigridia. We declare that we are functioning in wisdom, divine wisdom. Marakit sotara, the wisdom of the just. Lika sataya is abundant in us. Kira bando shatalabakataya. Reka sopre de galabashatalabaya. Mareko shakatarabaya. Mareko sontoribanabashataligrendo sondoya. Maleko sondoribanagalabashandanaba. Barakateri bondo shikredi bahasa marakato shindiri galabasandaya. The word of God is the wisdom of God. Barakasataya barakasata likruto shata. We walk in the word in the name of Jesus. Leke shunduri banakalabasataya yegrendo shatalabaya. Every Christian functions in the truth of God's word. Maleketo paya. We are not subject to deception. The eyes of our understanding are enlightened with the word, with the truth. Likra satalaba shundere kara marakero bondo shandalaba sekede barakato sondore baraba shekede at a barako sekede baraba shandaya. We thank you because Christ has been made unto us wisdom. Malego do shindiri galabasatala mando kobaradele mashaka balaketo paratala mando kobarade legrado brasiketo shikrende prosotoriba malikro sikrendo shindiri barabashonda malegrondo shandalabasata barakatala basata. We declare that every Christian is growing to maturity. They are coming to the knowledge of the truth. They are established in this present truth in the name of Jesus. Leke satala bakataya. They are not subject to doctrines of devils. They are not subject to deception. Mareko shatalabaya. We remondo koparataya. We declare legreto brondo seketarabaya kero mondo shandaya. Mareketo baya. That all our brethren and members are coming to maturity in every nation. In the name of Jesus. Legre sondala bakataya. Mareko shandalaba zegrendo sondere. Christ is made unto every one of us wisdom. Hallelujah. Rekoto para kalamando shandaya. Legrendo santalabaya. Malego brandalaba shandaya. We are directed by wisdom. Legrendo santalabaya. Marego do shandalabaya. Mendo sokrende baraba shandalaba. Marego santalaba. With all our getting, we are getting wisdom. With all our getting, we are getting understanding. With all our getting, we are going for the word of God, which is able to make us wise unto salvation. Glory to God. That word is able to make us wise unto salvation. That word is building us up. Hallelujah. That word is building us up. Hallelujah. That word is giving us inheritance among them that are sanctified. Glory. Makaso parata reto beto reparata lande. Lugaba shatala mando segrende sandaraba. Marego do shandalaba sendeya. Mendo segrede brashandara galaba. Legedo brondo shenere galaba. Verando sandalakia. Marego do shenere galaba sandalamando sene. Merondo shatalabaya. Marego do shenere galaba sata. Mendo sacradia. Rakato shenere baragalama sondere baragalaba shanda. Marakato shendere galaba sandalaba marego do shendere galaba sandalaba kero mondosh reketo sandaramandi rekato remanaba shandalaba marego do shendeya. Wisdom is exalted in the hearts of every Christian in the name of Jesus. Wisdom is exalted in the hearts of every Christian in every nation in
name of Jesus. Kerando paratene mando shadara barekta. Marego do shenere galabasandarabaya. Marego do brande kadabashandalaba. Marego do shenere galabasanta. Yes, this wisdom is profitable to direct in the name of Jesus. We receive divine direction by the power of the Holy Spirit. Mareko shatariaba. We know what to do. We are never confused. Wisdom is profitable to direct every member of the body of Christ in the name of Jesus. Kerabasataya, reketo parabaya, barandalaba shataya, mareketo sandalaba, barakato sandalabaya, marego do shenereba, reketo sandalabaya, kiromba shandalaba, rekato senerebaraba shonda, lekatarabando sondoya. That wisdom is producing testimonies. Lega sataya, mareketoya. We are in the right place at the right time, doing the right thing. Glory to God. Leke sombrandaya, mareketo shataya. We are always in the right place. We are always at the right time. Rigadara by shandaya, mareketora. We have the right words. That force of wisdom is causing us to do the unexpected. Hallelujah. Kirondo shataya, marekodo rebanama shandalaba. That wisdom caused Jesus to walk on water. Leketo paya, pareketo sata, rebarabaya. The wisdom of the just. Leke sotaya, mareketosha, marendo sada. We function in that wisdom. In the mighty name of Jesus, leketo parakata. At all times, hila mandara, under all circumstances. Glory to God. Mareketo rabaya, malekoto rabaya, piranda shataya, marekoto rabaya. We are guided by wisdom. Even in this time of deception, we are guided by wisdom. Mareketo shataya, marego no brende sone marakalaba shanda, marego do shenere galaba sete, maragato shenere galaba sandaya, marakato sendereba, reketo shatalabande, leketo ramande shekrene, leba baba yakta, lageto satalamande, reba baba baya kronde shenereba, rekataramando shenere gala, marego do shenere galaba sondore bakia, marakato sendereba nebo shondereba, reketo brandas keremando shanda, marakato sendereba, reba baya kosataraba, raketo parate lema jondarabande, rekataraba shandalaba, marekoto shandaraba reba sonda, marekoto rebaraba shandaraba, lekato brande, barekoto se brande, ligrando parate manda kiremondo sud, rekato remando shandaramande, reba baba baya kosataramande, regarabando shandalaba, malekoto robaya, maregoto shendereba, regalaba sondarabaya, leketo shandalaba shandalekaraba sonda, marekataraba, rebarabaraba. Yes, we function with that word. We function with that wisdom in the mighty name of Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We're still praying for Christians. I want us to read from the book of Psalm 1 from verse 1. It says, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law does he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Next verse. The ungodly are not so. There is a difference between the child of God and the unbelievers. And we heard so much of that during the last week, during the praise-a-ton. I want us to thank God for the glorious advantage that we have in the word of God and the wisdom of God that is available to us. Thanking him for every blessing that comes from his word. Thanking him for the differentiation of the church from the world. When men are cast down, we will say there's lifting up. Let's go ahead and thank him. Maraka shondola bakireba, magade brodo shakata labando sobrende kada, variko shoprede katabaya, malikroto shandale karabando sungrede bahita, marakato shondore balakalaba santalabado shikrende sidubondo, malakata labashata laba, bikrando sataya. We are above only and never beneath. In the name of Jesus, our path is a shining light. We shine brighter and brighter unto the perfect day. In the name of Jesus, lekra sata, everything we put our hands to do prospers. We give you thanks. We give you praise. We give you honor and glory. We give you praise. Just go ahead and thank him for the answers to prayers right now. Thank him because this is the confidence we have. We have prayed in his name and we receive answers to prayers.
Once again, I want to say a big thank you to my man of God for the opportunity to lead this segment of prayers.
Go ahead and worship him and thank him. Thank him for his love, for his grace, for his kindness. There's none like him. Give him praise and adoration. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Speak in other tongues. Most High God. Hola Sataraba Kande Kila Bakasilege Krose Tekila Antikis. In the Holy Ghost, speak in other tongues. you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Holy and righteous. Wherever you are, make sure to follow the lyrics. Thank you, Lord. Your kingdom reigns forever. We honor you. There's none like you. All the world is yours. All the nations belong to you. And all of us are the works of your hands. Thank you. Thank you that the Holy Spirit on the day of Pentecost was poured out upon all flesh throughout the earth. And man can be convicted by the Holy Ghost unto salvation. Thank you. Thank you. Through the ministry of the Holy Spirit, every ear can hear and every heart can understand. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your grace. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, if you've been standing, you may be seated. And the reason for this is so educated and informed because sometimes we do a lot of things because we're not properly informed. You need to be informed. Watch this.
Everything has gone up. Prices have skyrocketed.
With regard to food shortage, yes, we did. So talk about food shortages. And it's going to be real.
It's all about reduction of population, making food scarce.
One of the evil things they're doing right now is a fake scarcity of food. There's a lot of food, but then it's because something is being done to make food unavailable and under the control of certain powers.
In view of this evil reality, the deep state has sought to hijack a free gift of God to the nations, an all-important element required for daily human existence, food. And in turn, they have sought to wield food as a weapon against humanity through systematically orchestrated food scarcity. Essentially, this attempt by the globalists to dominate satanic agenda. This hideous work is a similar replay of gruesome previous events from history's timelines.
The year 1933. The place, the Soviet Union. In Ukraine, 3 million of them children.
This is the most terrible thing I've ever seen. It precisely because of the deliberation with which it was done and the total absence of even
and, of course, it was
very hard.
These kind of evil things and do them to others. Well, when you read the Bible, you see man's inhumanity to man. The Bible says the heart of man is desperately wicked. It says desperately wicked, who can know it? It says it's deceitful above all things and desperately wicked.
As sad as this was, today the globalists and present-day dictators in Mufti seek to plunge the world into this same valley of despair through orchestrated food scarcity. Currently, under the guise of protecting the planet, a direct attack is being meted out on nitrogen, a required necessity for agricultural produce and general soil health.
Nitrogen oxide is a fertilizer. It's a natural fertilizer, which causes the countryside to change. Mm-hmm. And what Dutch politicians have then done, they've spinned this as bad for nature and bad for the environment.
I've always said that the nitrogen crisis is, first of all, a made-up crisis. It's manufactured. And the only solution that is ever being proposed is forced expropriation.
I worked in the United States Senate Environment and Public Works Committee back in, it was 2007, the UN came out with their big agriculture report where they said that cow emissions were more harmful to the planet than all the trains, planes, and automobiles combined. And this was the beginning or the acceleration of going after the global food supply. Everywhere now, in Ireland, they're going to call 200,000 cows over 3 years to meet the net zero climate goals. Germany, this is their German newspaper, the Daily Bild, one sausage per month, according to the government's new proposal with the German Nutritional Society. This is real. It's happening. It's not theoretical. We're not talking about down the road.
So because the cows urinate, the cows, their breath is causing climate change. It's part of their activity to phase out the eating of beef.
As we go forward, as the United States just approved lab-grown meat, the United States is approving insects, and we have John Kerry now expanding this. They're already decimating farming in Australia, in Canada. We're seeing the results of it in all throughout Europe, and we saw the results of it in Sri Lanka, where the World Economic Forum touted their big non-modern organic, return to organic farming, and of course the whole country, the presidential palace, was overrun. So this is there's an old Chinese proverb, when there's food on the table, there are many problems. When there's no food, there's only one problem. And right now, we are facing a situation where they're creating intentional chaos and scarcity to force us to look, as they're saying, to buy insects, to buy this lab-grown meat.
While this attack on cows, beef, and nitrogen rages on, another arrow in the quiver of the globalists in their attack on food and starving the nations is through the use of genetically modified foods and seedlings.
Reject the genetically modified maize seeds that they are providing. Don't take them. They've been carefully including sperm neutralization.
According to The Guardian, in an article written more than 22 years ago, titled, Genetically Modified Corn, Set to Stop Man Spreading His Seed, scientists have created the ultimate GM crop, contraceptive corn. Waving fields of maize may one day save the world from overpopulation. The pregnancy prevention plants are the handiwork of the San Diego biotechnology company Epicyte, where researchers have discovered a rare class of human antibodies that attack sperm. By isolating the genes that regulate the manufacture of these antibodies, and by putting them in corn plants, the company has created tiny horticultural factories that make contraceptives.
A few years ago, a company known as the Monsanto Company, and they produced what they called a weed killer with a particular chemical that Roundup, glyphosate was the active agent, and they sold a lot. It became one of the biggest.
The manufacture of these antibodies, and by putting them in corn plants, the company has created tiny horticultural factories that make contraceptives.
A few years ago, they had a company known as the Monsanto Company, and they produced what they called a weed killer with a particular chemical that was branded Roundup, glyphosate was the active agent, and they sold a lot. It became one of the biggest companies in the US, and they've been there for a long time. But their product was responsible for cancer.
There is also a growing body of evidence indicating that the abundant use of pesticides has caused a rise in adverse health effects, including cancer. Most infamously, the world's most widely used herbicide, glyphosate, a product of agrigiant Monsanto, now owned by Bayer, has been linked to a number of cases of cancer and resulted in multiple billion-dollar settlements against the company.
First diagnosis was pretty bad. You know, they were saying that I could probably die within a couple of years. So mine is one of the most aggressive forms of non-Hodgkin lymphoma that they've pretty much ever seen. So a company like that has money. They can fight a long time. Like I said, this fight might go past my life.
Lee Johnson sued Monsanto and won. The jury awarded him $289 million in August of 2018 after concluding his cancer was linked to exposure to Roundup, Monsanto's controversial toxic weed killer.
There's a man, Professor Seralini, he did a research on them because they got their license from showing that rats were able to survive it after the rats had been put through it for a certain number of days. But Professor Seralini said, let's look at it through 2 years and put the rats through 2 years having their food and water laced with glyphosate. They all had tumors. 80% of them had tumors.
As a scientist and as the lead author of this two-year study, do you think there are implications for human health from GMOs?
Of course, I think there are severe implications for human health due to my research. We have demonstrated clearly that in males, especially livers and kidneys were reached at a very high level. Kidneys were also rich in females, but females were prone to big mammary tumors.
One of the major studies to show potential harms is the 2012 Seralini study, named for the lead researcher.
They were convicted of actually that Agent Orange was safe. They told us that DDT was safe, and now they're in charge of telling us if their own genetically modified foods are safe. Because the FDA doesn't require a single safety study, they leave it to Monsanto. The White House had instructed the FDA to promote biotechnology under the first Bush administration. And so the FDA created a new position for Michael Taylor, Monsanto's former attorney. So Michael Taylor was in charge of policy at the FDA when this GMO policy was created, and then he became Monsanto's vice president, and under the Obama administration was put back in the FDA as the U.S. food safety czar. In reality, the overwhelming consensus among the scientists at the FDA were not only that GMOs were different, but that they were inherently dangerous, that they might create allergies, toxins, new diseases, and nutritional problems. They had urged their superiors to require long-term study, and when they saw drafts of the policy coming back to them, they were angry and urged their political appointees to change course. But Michael Taylor and the political appointees ignored the science, ignored the scientists, denied the existence of their concerns, and set forth a policy that allowed GMOs to be put on the market in a way that creates unprecedented risk for human beings and the environment.
I mean, when I became secretary, given the fact that I was in charge of the department and regulating agriculture, I had a lot of pressure on me not to push the issue too far, so to speak. But I would say even when I opened my mouth in the Clinton administration, I got slapped around a little bit by not only the industry, but also some of the people even in the administration. In fact, I made a speech once saying that we needed to be more, we needed more thoughtfully think through the regulatory issues on GMOs. And I had some people within the Clinton administration, particularly in the U.S. trade area, that were very upset with me. They said, how could you in agriculture be questioning our regulatory regime?
Listen, we're dealing with a demented, psychopathic group of elites. You have to understand. And why this is important is this. They are desperate. They say a population of 500 million is what the world needs. Do you know what that means? That is the elimination, extermination of billions of people. So make no mistakes about this. This is serious. This is huge.
Now, why am I telling you this? Because, see, as God's people, if you don't know the truth, you pray wrong. All the time you're praying to God, you're praying, God bless our country. He blessed your country.
Yes, sir.
There's a thief.
Yes. Yes.
There's a thief that's destroying it.
Yes.
And when you understand this, then you know how to pray. Because God loves everybody. God loves all the people in your country. And he doesn't like it when certain individuals somewhere are taking advantage of the people in your nation.
Yes, sir.
God doesn't like it.
Yes, sir.
And that's why he said to us to pray for all men.
Yes.
And for the leaders.
Yes, sir.
Pray for all men.
Yes, sir.
He's done his part by blessing all the nations.
Yes, sir.
Pray for them that those who weaken the nations will be unable to continue this nefarious activities, this evil works that they've been doing for so long.
Prayers offered by those who have God's approval are effective. James 5 verse 16.
I hope you understood what we just showed you. We have to be watchful and prayerful. Remember the words of Jesus. He said, watch and pray. Watch and pray. Watch and pray. You cannot leave such decisions to political leaders, Because some of them are not even, they're not aware. They don't even know what we're talking about. They don't. Some of them don't. In fact, let me read something to you, what the Bible tells us. In Daniel chapter 4, there's a story that Nebuchadnezzar tells about his dream to Daniel. And then after he told Daniel of his dream, he wanted the interpretation of this dream. But there's a part of that dream that was very significant. About this tree that was to be cut down. And then gets to the 15th verse of the 4th chapter, book of Daniel. Nevertheless, leave the stump of his roots in the earth, even with a band of iron and brass in the tender grass of the field. And let it be wet with the dew of heaven, and let his portion be with the beasts in the grass of the earth. Let his heart be changed from man's, and let a beast's heart be given unto him, and let seven times pass over him. And this is quite significant because in the interpretation, it means that the subject of this dream was Nebuchadnezzar himself, because he had gotten a warning from God and he didn't heed it. And the Bible says in his dream, he was to be given the heart of a beast. In other words, he would become like an animal and go into the bush and live like one of the beasts of the field. And it says, let seven times pass over him. In the book of Daniel, that means 7 years. So for 7 years, he would live like an animal, like a beast. And then at the end of that period, he'll come back and continue to be king. Now that's extraordinary. Because somebody who lived like a beast would come into the palace and continue to run the country, run the empire. And here's what he said about that. I want you to look at verse 17, chapter 4, book of Daniel. This matter is by the decree of the watchers and the demand by the word of the holy ones, to the intent that the living may know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men and giveth it to whomsoever he will and set it up over it the basest of men. That's remarkable. He set it over it the basest of men, which means that God can take even those who are non-compos mentis and put them on the throne of empires. Imagine that. And that's exactly what happened there. So we can't just leave things for those in office to make the decisions. We've got to pray. If we can control things in the realm of the spirit, they will be controlled in the earth. Because the spiritual controls the material, controls the physical. Always remember that. And I'll just take you straight into discussing the message of the month. I want to show you a couple of things. Romans chapter 8. We're going to read from verse 26
Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. Next verse. And he that searcheth the hearts knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit, because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose. I want us to take a look again at those verses from verse 26. He says, likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. The word that's translated helpeth is a complex Greek word. And helpeth is a very simplistic way of putting it. It's the word sonanti lambanomai. It's one word, but comes from different words put together that actually, when you put them together, it means to hold or to take hold together against. It also means to take hold together from the opposite side. But it is literally to take hold together against. And that presupposes that one is joining together forces together to work against another. Following what I'm saying. So when you understand that, now let's go back to reading it the way it is. Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. So what does he do with us? He takes hold together with us in our infirmities against. So in our weakness, in our limitations, the Holy Spirit takes hold together with us. So we form a force together against whatever it is that comes against us. So the Holy Spirit helps us, he says, for we know not what we should pray for as we are. Now, the only other place that this term is used is in a more subtle form, and something that's got to do with a story that many of you would know very well. I want to take you there. Oh, glory be to God. Go to St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 10. We got a story here. How Jesus went to the home
of matter in Mary and their brother Lazarus. And the story goes that Jesus was speaking, teaching, and Mary went to sit at his feet and listen to his message. But then it tells us something about matter. I want you to observe the construction here in the 40th verse. Well, let's read from verse 39. Luke's Gospel, chapter number 10. And she had a sister called Mary, which also sat at Jesus' feet and heard his word. But Martha was cumbered about much serving. She was cumbered. I want you to observe what it says there. She was cumbered. Now, let's read from the RSV. He says, but Martha was distracted with much serving. And she went to him, she went to Jesus and said, Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to serve alone? Tell her then to help me. It's the word sunanti lambanomai. See, to come take hold together with me. Why? Because here she's distracted. I want to understand what's going on in the mind of this individual. She's not just saying, come and help me to fix the food. It's more than that. Come and help me because this thing is getting on my nerves. She's troubled. I need some help. So it's not only going to be just helping me make the food, but this will help me calm my mind. And Jesus understood what was going on. Look at the master's reply. The Lord answered her, Martha, Martha, you are anxious and troubled about many things. You see, it wasn't just the food and the serving. You are anxious and troubled about many things. The master discerned her problem, understood what was afflicting her mind. Glory to God. So imagine that you find yourself in such a situation, distracted by many things. The Bible says, likewise, the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, comes to our aid. He helps us in that situation so that our minds can become calmed, so that we can have some composure and be successful in whatever it is that we have to do. Let's read it again from that 26th verse of the 8th chapter, book of Romans. Likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we should pray for as we ought. We don't even know what to pray for as we ought. We don't know the details. How do I get about praying on this situation that I'm going through? Because you don't know what the Holy Spirit does. So now let's read it from that RSV one more time. Romans chapter 8, yeah. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But the Spirit himself intercedes for us with sighs too deep for words. Sighs too deep for words. Deep sighs. Deep sighs. Too deep for words, he says. Sighs too deep for words. Have you ever tried praying and when you were praying about something, words didn't come out of your mouth? You didn't have words to speak to God. Couldn't even speak in tongues, because he's not referring to speaking in tongues here, because when you speak in tongues, you are given utterance by the Holy Ghost. You are given words by the Holy Ghost. So words in another language, in the spiritual language, they are still words. But in this situation, they are sighs too deep for words. Groanings, the old King James translation refers to them as groanings. Groanings. Look at that again, the KJV. It says, likewise, the Spirit also helped our infirmities, for we know not what we should pray for as we ought, but the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. Groans, sighs, like you're crying. You don't even know why. Sobbing. Words are not coming out of your mouth. You can't even pray in tongues at that point. See, you're just sobbing. Sobbing. Yes. The 27th verse. And he that searcheth the hearts, who is that? God Almighty. God the Father. He that searcheth the hearts knoweth. He knows what is the mind of the Spirit because he maketh. Because he maketh. Because the Holy Ghost who's taking hold together with us, the Holy Ghost maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. He maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. That means whatever it is that you're praying about will be answered because you're praying by the power and direction of the Holy Ghost. See, he's taken hold together. See, he props us up in our weakness, helps us. Glory be to God. Makes intercession for the saints according to the will of God. And when that happens, look at the next verse. That's the result. And we know that all things work together for good. See, when you pray like that, you just know everything is going to be all right. Everything's going to turn out for your good. Hallelujah. And you can get out of there saying, it's going to work out for my good. Going to work out for my good. You just know it. You just know it. We know that all things work together. See, you can't just claim that all things will work together for your good if you don't pray like this. It's conditioned on the ministry of the Holy Spirit. So verse 28 is based on verses 26 and 27. You want everything to always turn out for your good. Then practice 26 and 27. Hallelujah. Oh, this is beautiful. So we have a role to play. If you read in Colossians chapter 4, and in verse number 12, he gives us an example of somebody who prayed like this. Epaphras, who is one of you, meaning that he was from the church in Colossae. Epaphras, who is one of you, a servant of Christ, saluted you. So he was one of their members, but at this time, he was visiting with Paul the apostle. Epaphras, who is one of you, a servant of Christ, saluted you, always laboring fervently for you in prayers, that he may stand perfect and complete in all the will of God. Look at that. He says, Epaphras labors fervently for you in prayers. How do you labor in prayer? That's interesting, right? Laboring in prayer. What's translated laboring fervently, broken into two words there, is just, it's one Greek word, agonizomai. It means to, the English gets the word agonize from there. It means to strive. It means to contend for something. You get into a contest to contend with the adversary. That's what it means. So if that is true, as it is, it does mean that Epaphras got into a contention with some force in behalf of the Christians in Colossae. That suddenly he couldn't be fighting God. No, he wouldn't be contending with God. It must be some other force, some evil force. So he's taking hold in prayer together with them against. See. And that's the same word. It's a verb. All right? That's the same word. Agonizomai. It's a verb. It's the same word that's translated fight in 1 Timothy chapter 6 when you read from verse number 12. Can we look at it? Here is, you fight the good fight of faith. Fight the good fight. It's a good fight. It says fight, fight, fight the good fight. First word is agonizomai, the verb fight. Fight the good fight. Agon is the noun, good fight. So who are you fighting? God? No. So he's already told you, the Holy Spirit, who is God, the Holy Spirit takes hold together with you against your adversary. Now, there are interesting benefits of praying like this, praying for others, see, interceding for others. There are amazing benefits. And let me take you through a couple of simple ones. Genesis chapter 20. Genesis chapter 20. In Genesis chapter 20, there's something very, very significant. And the story goes, well, you can go to the 17th verse. The story goes that Abimelech, a king, had taken Abraham's wife, Sarah, because she was beautiful. And Abraham, of course, because he was afraid, had said she was his sister. So Abimelech took the lady until God talked to Abimelech in the night. In a dream, God said to him, "Abimelech, restore that man his wife immediately or I'll kill you." I'll show that to you. Let me read it to you. Look at it in verse six, from verse six, same book, Genesis chapter 20. And God said unto him in a dream, "Yea, I know that thou didst this in the integrity of thy heart, for I also withheld thee from sinning against me. Therefore suffered I thee not to touch her. Now therefore restore the man his wife, for he is a prophet, and he shall pray for thee, and thou shalt live. And if thou restore her not, know thou that thou shalt surely die. Thou and all that are thine, everything that belongs to you will die. You and everything, your whole family will die, if you don't restore the man his wife. I'll kill all of you." So Abimelech, of course, very quickly did that. But here's the interesting thing, the thing I want you to observe. At this time, Abraham had a promise that he was going to have a son through his wife Sarah, but no pregnancy as yet. He's still confessing, he's still declaring, right? See, sometimes when you are in a situation, God's got to get you guided into some spiritual principles that will help you, and he is one of them. So God said to him, go to Abraham, restore him his wife, and he will pray for you. He will pray for you. He will pray for you. So go to verse 17 now. So Abraham prayed unto God, and God healed Abimelech and his wife and his maidservants, and they bare children. All right? Now, that doesn't mean all of them gave birth at the same time. But in fact, the word children is not even in the original, frankly, okay? Which means that they were able to bear. Because, look at the next verse. For the Lord had fast closed up all the wombs of the house of Abimelech because of Sarah, Abraham's wife. Everybody, including the goats and the dogs, they were all made barren because of Sarah, Abraham's wife. God closed up all their wombs, man and beast. Okay, now, look at that verse 17 again. So Abraham prayed unto God, and God healed Abimelech and his wife and his maidservants, and they bare children. Now, remember, the book was not written in chapters and verses. Look at the next verse. Go to the next verse. After he prayed for them, it says, and the Lord visited Sarah as he had said, and the Lord did unto Sarah as he had spoken. That's remarkable. When he prayed for Abimelech, so that Abimelech's house, Abimelech's wife and his whole house would be able to bear children, it happened for him too. His wife was suddenly also able to receive the same miracle. Did you see that? That's wonderful. That is wonderful. That is wonderful. Glory be to God. Okay, let me show you another example. Now you go straight to the book of Job, chapter 42. We have the same situation, a similar situation, where God tells Job's friends, they were all good men, all right? And you remember the story of Job. He had several things happen to him. He lost all his wealth. Everything was gone, including his children. In fact, his wife told him to curse God and die. He'd lost everything. And his friends came to see him. And they were speculating about what might have led to his sudden downfall. They speculated on several things and preached a lot of messages to him to repent of some sin that he might have committed, which they weren't sure about. They said to him, you definitely did something wrong. That's why this is happening to you. And finally, after everything, God said to Job's friends, you didn't say the right thing. You were wrong. And God said to them, now you go to Job and ask him to pray for you, because I'll listen to him. I'm not going to listen to you. So they went to Job. Now, Job could have said, you've said enough. Please, I don't see any of you. He had an option. God asked them to go to him and ask him to pray for them. He could have refused. It could have been better. I'm not going to pray for you. I'm angry at all of you. But no. Here's what the Bible tells us. Go to verse 10. And the Lord restored the fortunes of Job when he had prayed for his friends. So when he prayed for his friends, everything turned for his good. Because he prayed for his friends. Look at it. The Lord restored the fortunes of Job when he had prayed for his friends. And the Lord gave Job twice as much as he had before. He was already, listen, this man was already the richest. The Bible tells us, you read the beginning of this book, the Bible tells us he was the richest in all the East. He was the richest before he lost everything. Then God restored to him everything and made him twice as rich as he was before. Hallelujah. So it's back to number one spot. Isn't that right? Beautiful, beautiful. But what I want you to observe is that God restored the fortunes of Job when he had prayed for his friends. Not before he prayed for them. When he prayed for his friends. There's a benefit in praying for others. Are you listening to me now? There's a benefit in praying for others when you take your attention away from yourself. I always remember that gentleman. You know, we've seen lots and lots of miracles, but there are some significant things that get our attention. So we're over one of those venues many years ago, ministering in a program we titled Day of Bliss. And there was a guy who was so, so sick. Very sick. They actually helped him to get in there. And he was sitting, waiting, hoping for a miracle. But then he saw another guy that was in a terrible condition. He said this later. He said, when I saw him, I stopped praying for myself. He said, I began to pray for him. See, he took his attention away from himself and began to pray for that other guy who was in a terrible condition. He forgot about himself. And then, to his amazement, and of course, great pleasure, the guy he was praying for, as we began to pray and release the power of God upon the congregation, that guy suddenly got healed and got up and started walking towards a platform. He was rejoicing in his seat, and the power of God went through his body, and he got up, even though he had stopped praying for himself and was praying for someone else. See, God will make happen to you and for you what you make happen for others. Remember it. Don't forget it. Don't forget it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This month of April is the month of intercession. You're going to pray for others. So organize yourself. Organize your schedule. Organize your cells. Organize your groups. Organize your church for intercession this month. Plan for it, prepare for it, and be a part of it. And intercede. 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 And what you make happen for others will happen for you. Take your attention away from yourself. Give attention to the needs of others this month. This month. Glory be to God. This month, be concerned about what others are going through. Be concerned. And make up your mind. Through prayer, you will effect changes. Through prayer, you will effect changes. Right now, I want you to pray. Pray. Pray in the Spirit. Thank God for the message of this month and for the things that we will accomplish in the realm of the Spirit. Pray that the Lord will also guide you in planning your schedule for intercession. Keep praying. Pray everywhere. The month of intercession. In the prayer of intercession, you are praying for others, not yourself. You're praying for others. You're taking hold together with them against their adversaries or some adversity or some challenges in their lives. But you're taking hold together with them, like the Holy Spirit takes hold together with us. And you are also going to allow and encourage this ministry of the Holy Spirit in your life this month. This month. This is the month of intercession. You will intercede by the Holy Ghost. You will intercede for others. You seize the opportunity to effect changes. See, when we pray together, nothing can stop us. Nothing. Nothing can stop us. Remember what I shared with you. It's true that sometimes, even in different kinds of institutions, he says that leaders can be from among the basest of men. Think about it. That's a massive revelation. So leaders are not always necessarily among the smartest people. I'm talking about people who become leaders of nations or empires. You can look at the history of the Roman Empire, for example. That emperors who didn't know where they were at any given time. And they were there. They were there as emperors. So how do you rely on them to make the right decisions? So I meant it when I said that leaders, even today, you have them who are non-compos mentis. So you can't just, you can't let that pass by. The scripture I read to you, you have to look at it. The basis of men, yes. Some have even thought that that just meant being lowly in heart. No, it doesn't mean lowly in heart, because it's in context. See? It's in context. It's talking about a man being given an animal's heart, a beast's heart, as an example, as an illustration. That's terrible. That's terrible. It happens in different fields. It happens in different fields. So this month, we must pray as we should. It tells us to pray for all men and for leaders. We have to. Glory be to God. I believe this is the first communion service since we had the healing streams, right? Yes. So again, I'd like to express appreciation to all of you who worked hard with us for the healing streams that we had in the month of March. It was glorious. It was wonderful. It changed the lives of many. And lots of people were healed. And then we had the Festival of Miracles that followed. I think we did it for about a week or so, 2 weeks. But we really wanted to continue. Are we going to do one more? Another week. When is that? We're starting on Monday. Okay, you just heard it. So we're going to start on Monday, another week of Festival of Miracles, where they can call in, people can call in from all over the world and share their amazing testimonies on the live program. It's from 4 p.m. to 6. 4 to 6. Every day? Every day from Monday on the Healing Streams TV. And of course, it'll be live on the networks as well. So from 4 p.m., GMT plus one. Okay, wonderful. I think we should show you a brief video highlights of that program. Watch this.
It was a fiesta of inexplicable miracles, an incredible crusade of healing and wonders, a momentous weekend with divinity, and a rendezvous of phenomenal feats. For 3 great days, billions of people across the face of the earth congregated for exceptional moments of inconceivable wonders, astonishing miracles, and marvelous blessings at the March 2024 Healing Streams Live Healing Services with Pastor Chris. This lavish demonstration of God's healing power and yet another pace-setting mega healing and miracle crusade was beamed in real time from the Healing Streams TV to over 7 billion people, hosted in millions of virtual and on-site healing centers, which were set up in every city, nation, territory, and continent of the earth, and was simultaneously translated into 8,130 languages of the globe. Great shouts of celebrations reverberated across the globe as the world witnessed the unraveling of God's resplendent grace and the confirmation of His Word at the entrance of the man of God, Pastor Chris, into the auditorium. In a lavish display of God's power and authority, He ministered healing and restoration to the sick, oppressed, and all who waited in high anticipation on the healing line. All manners of infirmities were instantaneously displaced in the name of Jesus, and many who were made free liberally demonstrated their newfound healing, ability, and strength. Showing great compassion for the enfeebled, the man of God ministered to batches of sick people in wheelchairs, concurrently casting out demons of pain, sickness, and torment in the name of Jesus Christ.
You, and 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 you. In the name of Jesus, get up on your feet.
In a dynamic display of God's all-surpassing power and matchless might, the man of God, Pastor Chris, directed divine healing and restoration to certain individuals on the healing line through potent prophetic utterances, thus effecting a supernatural release in the health circumstances and challenges that have ensnared them for protracted periods.
Come. Yes. I see you're holding your card, right? Because you've been suffering from diabetes, right? Yeah. But what is even more serious for you is a heart problem. And they try to treat you, but nothing's working. And that's why you came here. See, I'm right. I'm right. Right under it is written hypertension. The reason is because a devil entered into your life. You were afraid you're going to die. No, you're not going to die. You're not going to die. Why am I saying something about your knees? Do you have any problem with your knees? Come on, tell me. What happened?
The lung.
Yes. For many years, you've had pains in your knees. Yeah. But you, in your card, you only complained of glaucoma. Yeah? But God's going to heal everything now.
Amen.
Including your knees.
Amen.
Precious Father, the confusion in his heart is gone. Don't worry about your future. He's taking charge. From this very moment, as you're standing here, from this very moment, he will lead you like a father. He will lead you. Are you hearing me? Precious Father, that devil is out of him. Thank you, Lord. You're healed. Move your knees. Go like this. Do it again. Now kneel. Go on your knees. Good. Good. Now get up.
I suffered this condition for 2 years.
Don't cry. Don't cry. It's hard to believe you're 40 years old. Don't cry. Everything is changing now.
Glory to God!
Everything is changing now.
This is the year of restoration. Years are being added to this man.
Thou spirit of darkness. You have afflicted a man. Come here. Just look at me. In the name of Jesus Christ, I bring you healing from all your infirmities and all your regrets. All right? All your regrets. because God is helping you start your life afresh. You are healed.
Glory to God, He's healed.
Look around. Look this way. You are the only one left. Do you notice? Come.
The depth of the love of God. The depth of the love of God.
Look around again. Where is everybody? You are the only one left.
Love of God is so precious, so deep.
Because of your condition, it's the reason your feet are swollen, right? Sela gom praticos kojeziva para eredeos koshenamantiki. You know, I'm ministering to a lot of people right now, all over the world. So I can't say many things to you, but your sins are forgiven you. All right? Your sins are forgiven you. Violence is not good. Anger is not good. So will you let anger go? Yes. Did you hear what I said? Do you know what I'm talking about?
Yes, Pastor.
How do you know?
That is my nature. I'm always angry.
Say it again.
That is my nature. I'm always angry.
So, from today, no more, right? You are free.
This man just received a new heart, a new life, a new destiny. Just because of the love of God. And that's it! Look at him go!
The culminating moments of these extraordinary healing services were electrifying as the man of God, Pastor Chris, unleashed special blessings of healing and transformations upon billions of participants who were connected from around the world.
In the name of Jesus Christ, I speak to every infirm spirit. I speak to every devil of disease. You demons of blindness, deafness, dumbness. In the name of Jesus Christ, come out of their bodies.
There was great rejoicing as every limitation and barrier was removed with great rapidity, and people everywhere rejoiced and glorified the Lord for their healing.
Fast on the heels of the 10th Healing Streams live healing services with Pastor Chris came a glorious season of intense celebration, as many around the world have come forth to testify about their exceptional healing experience. The profound impact, astounding miracles, and dynamic blessings that were unleashed through these services.
So as part of preparation of Healing Streams live healing services with Pastor Chris, my sister got a contact of one deaf and dumb school. The name of the school is Ayodhya Charitable Trust, which is in Pune. She got the contact, but they decided to give us time on Saturday, which was the second day of healing services. So we decided to organize a healing center in that deaf and dumb school. And we had an interpreter over there who was a translator between us and them. So we arranged it. And then as we started showing them the Healing Streams Live services, so in there, we started showing them the testimonies first. After the testimonies, when our man of God came, we showed them that part when pastor came to minister the ones who were there in the hall. And the children started looking to pass towards pastor. So as pastor started ministering the deaf and dumb, we asked them to put their fingers in their ears. And we also laid hands with faith on them. And once the prayer was done, we found out one of our sisters just snapped a finger at one of the boys, and he started hearing it. Hallelujah. So we started to test them. What we did is we asked them to sit backwards, seeing backwards in an opposite direction, and we just clapped over there to see who are the ones are able to hear. And we saw, glory to God, there were more than 16 students who started to hear again. Oh, glory to God. Praise the Lord. What an amazing miracle it was. Thank you, Pastor, so much for your love and the healing you're taking to the entire world.
Then the edition really was so, so special. We reached Pastor four countries from the Middle East.
Praise God.
Egypt, and we had several centers in Egypt, and Jordan, and Syria, and Algeria. And in the second day, one of the centers, it happened in the same day, three testimonies.
Wow.
Praise God. It's striking this happened day, that in the same day, there is a lady who was attending with us in the center. And this day, in the morning, she was going to make a surgery operation in her spine. But when the man of God was praying for her, she received her miracle. Hallelujah, hallelujah, praise God, praise God. She didn't need the operation, she didn't go for the operation, and she was jumping, and she was doing what she couldn't do before, and it was super amazing. It was so, so amazing. And thank God, these things came. The 10th edition was really so special in Egypt, and was bigger than any other time before. So thank you, dear man of God. And we love you here in Egypt dearly. Thank you, sir.
5 years ago, I was diagnosed with cancer. And it's been really tough between the medication and the disease. I wasn't able to do much. I spent a lot of days just lying down on the couch in bed. Not able to walk far. 5 minutes, I would be out of energy. Going up the stairs was a chore. Whenever I would get all the way up, I'd be out of breath. It was hard to bend down to get things for myself. I always had to leave things on the counter for my daughter to put away or to because I could not bend. Well, things have changed.
Hallelujah!
When Pastor Chris ministered on me,
Rizzo, you are here.
My pain, I had a lot of pain. My pain disappeared.
You're free.
I can bend. I wasn't able to bend down. I could put my socks on. I could put my shoes on. I can go all the way down.
Oh, glory to God.
Hallelujah.
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 Oh, praise God.
I tried to run up the stairs like I used to do a long time ago. And it's possible.
Praise God. Praise God.
Zu einem Heilungsgottesdienst.
Pastor Juliana invited me on the 17th of March to a healing center here in Germany. The service was not boring at all. I was very excited, and I watched the program with a lot of expectations. And during the program, as Pastor Chris prayed, my back pain, that is the spinal cord pain that I had for over 10 years, was relieved, was gone.
Wow! Praise God!
Praise God!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Wow.
First of all, I can move very freely. Before, I couldn't climb the stairs because it was difficult for me. But now, I can do it very easily. I feel so strong now, since the pain is not there. I'm also born again, and that is very wonderful for me. As Pastor Chris prayed for those who have not received Jesus Christ, I also received Christ on that same day.
J'étais tombé malade dans le mois de mai.
I felt sick seriously in the month of May.
Vraiment ça n'allait pas.
Nothing was going well.
Je suis resté dans ce état pendant 3 mois à 4 mois.
And I stayed in that sickness for 3 to 4 months.
Vraiment dans ce état j'étais là, c'était tellement critique que je n'arrivais pas à manger.
And in the state where I was, it was so critical that I could not eat at the time.
J'ai fait plusieurs semaines même sans manger, boire, je n'arrivais pas à boire de l'eau.
And I spent many weeks without eating and without drinking self.
Je ne pouvais pas marcher ni voir même.
I could not walk and I could not see also.
Mes amis m'ont dit de participer et ce que vraiment le pasteur Chris pouvait faire pour moi.
And my friends told me, go and participate to the healing streams and the man of God, Pastor Chris, can pray for you, you will be healed.
Donc j'ai participé au flux de guérison en direct avec mon téléphone.
So I participated to the healing stream on my phone.
À ce flux de guérison, vraiment la vue était encore faible. Malgré les plaies, avait un peu disparu, mais la vue, il n'arrivait pas à voir.
My visibility was still very low. My visibility was still
et
very...
vraiment quand j'ai suivi les flux de guérison jusqu'au dernier jour, jusqu'à aujourd'hui, il voit clairement.
I followed the healing stream
tous mes yeux
from the one to the last
day.
And everything, I'm still
you are totally
well.
Healed now.
My eyes are totally
because
healed.
You know, I saw the picture. See perfectly well. Talking perfectly well.
Parlant bien.
All the pores are ceased to come out. Everything has disappeared.
Total disparu. Une différence totale.
Total transformation.
Une transformation totale.
That could not have been imagined.
Que personne n'aurait pu imaginer.